Hello folks, this is Peter Phelps back again. I'm going to be doing a three-part design video series. This one's pretty much a simple project that can be made with cement blocks, 2x4s, 4x4s, and with the various metal pieces, and I would use 3-inch probably deck screws to do this project. But overall, it's I'm going to break it up into three parts because it's really simple and it should make it easier to understand what we're doing as the parts build on each other. But for right now, we're going to design the cement block, which is, you know, everybody knows cement blocks. They're used in so many different places. You can buy them at almost any hardware store, and I am working still in inches and feet, just to let you know. And we'll go ahead and get on with this. This is part design. I'm going to create a new sketch, and I'm going to choose the YZ plane. Say okay. I'm gonna zoom out here some, and I'm gonna start off just making a box. I'm gonna start at the origin, go up, go like that. Now I'm gonna draw two more boxes inside. Escape to get out of that. Now, normally I'd like to have these over here. And height of it is 7 5/8. So we'll go 7 + 5/8 and then put the inch and say okay. And then we'll make the length 15.5 inches. So 15.5. Say okay. Zoom out a bit. I'll move the boxes. All I'm doing is clicking and dragging on the lines here. This is going to be 4 3/4. It's okay. And we're going to make it this and this equal heights. So I'm clicking on the one control, holding and clicking on the next. I'm going to make them. And the other side is 5.5. So 5.5. So okay. And then take this and go make this one equal. Alright, and then there is 1.5 inches between here and here, both directions. So You could use a decimal here. It will change it over on its own. And we're going to do the same thing on this side. Let's see if I can move. Alright, now we have a fully constrained sketch of what the cement block would look like. Now, the true cement block isn't square on all this. It actually has some fillets, so we're going to make a small fillet into each of these. Let me see if I can find that's this one. Now it's readjusted all the way. So we might have to do some adjustment because it's definitely not. What I'm going to do first though is I'm going to set the radius on the, I'm thinking like half an inch. So now I gotta select that, this, and this, set those all to equal, and then we're gonna have to go back. I probably should have done the fillets before I set the distances. I hit escape. Click here, here. Give it 1.5. Here, here. 1.5. And because we changed those fillets, we're going to have to go back and change the dimensions on the other thing. So let's go finish this part. Because that got rid of the equals ones. By changing the corners into fillets, you change the dimensions of the boxes themselves, I believe. Back to here, click on this one up here, give that a So that did the remaining 4 3/4, so we'll leave it alone there. Maybe it did keep my dimensions. Let's see. No, that's 5 1/8 instead of 5 1/2. Okay, now we're back to being a constrained sketch. Should have all the right dimensions. Let's close that. And let's take a look at it. So that's the profile of our cement block, and then I'm going to pad that, and it's going to pad 7 5/8, 7 say okay, and that now creates our very simple cement block that we use. Some people call them cinder blocks, but it's used in so many different construction projects, it's crazy. So we're going to take that and we're going to save it. Seeing it right now, so I'm just going to make a new one. And I'm going to call this the staircase project. Stairs project. And then I'm going to export that also out, because I want to use the STL in the next, in the third part of this, rather than this itself. So, export. You can do an AMF if you wanted, but I don't want to, guess. STL. Cement block. Alright, so that's basically the basis of this first part of this three-part series. It's just a simple cement block with holes in it. So, you could use, you know, they have several other types of cement blocks with different holes. Just basically change what the holes look like and where they're placed in your file, and you can do the same thing. It's no big deal. So thanks for watching and goodbye.